What is the strategy for keeping this story and this scandal simple for people to understand?
Defense dollars for dirt. That's what was going on here. But I think, you know, Bill Taylor laid out something, you know, in his transcript, which is important. He said that undoubtedly, without this security assistance, more Ukrainians will die.
Yeah.
We're a very compassionate people.
Yeah.
And even more so than I think sometimes I thought when over the last few weeks there was concern about, you know, the potential genocide of the Kurds by the Turks. And that really bothered, you know, Republicans and Democrats. Mm-hmm. When people start to hear in public that every day dollars were held up for the Ukrainians, those were Ukrainians who were dying in the eastern part of their country.
But you're talking about the serious things that, that motivate and compel truthful testimony from men and women like Fiona Hill, like Marie Yovanovitch, like Ambassador Bill Taylor. And there is that really powerful news account about Bill Taylor sort of standing where he could see the Russian threat. There used to be Republicans in Congress who felt that way too. But I mean, I think it's more likely that you see circus animals in the public hearings. I mean, how do you combat the life and death nature and the seriousness of this with the lunacy from House Republicans? The protests, the questions in here.
And the stunts that they'll likely, you know, try and carry out. But these are serious witnesses. You know, these are not the president's friends, as, you know, some in the past have testified, and, you know, they had credibility issues. Serious witnesses.
You're talking about Michael Cohen?
Yeah.
Roger Stone, Paul Manafort, Corey all those Lodowski. Friends in jail.
Yeah. So serious witnesses, credible, and also people who have a lot of character. And that's going to come out. That's what came out in our, you know, deposition hearings. They also have no dog in the fight. I mean, these people,
right. They
go overseas, put their heads down for 2 to 3 years. They're away from their family. They're away from their home country, serving in the interest of the United States. And this is going to be one of the most patriotic things they can do, which is defy the president's orders that they don't come in and just tell the truth.
How does this end?
Well, we're going to put the best case forward. I think the allegation is extortion, essentially. And we're going to put credible witnesses forward. It's pretty clear that all the arrows point in the direction that the president was leading this scheme. But I think the best case also is a fair case. It's not just the facts behind the case. The public has to perceive it as the president had his day in court, and then it's, you know, in the Senate's court. But all I can do is one of the investigators now is to put forth a fair case.